we know that sound waves are associated with pressure variations, so the pressure will be varying inside the pipes. So how do we know where the pressure is higher, where is the pressure lower? So what we notice is that around the nodes, at some points, the air particles are all pushed towards the nodes, and half a period later, the particles are always pushed away, because on either side of the node, the displacement is always in the opposite direction. So when the air molecules are pushed together, we have high pressure, whereas when the air molecules are pushed away from the node, we have a low pressure. On the other hand, around the antinodes, the displacement of the particles is always in the same direction. If the displacement is positive, well, then all particles near the antinodes are displaced in the positive direction, and there's hardly any variation between the pressure. If the displacement is maximum negative, then all the particles around the antinodes are displaced in negative direction, so the distance between the particles is basically constant. And we find, therefore, that the pressure variation is actually the greatest at the displacement nodes. So a displacement node corresponds to a pressure antinode, and a displacement antinode corresponds to a pressure node. So what we have here is at the top a diagram that shows how the air molecules are moving, and this black diagram shows for all the particles in the tube how the displacement varies with time. And we have our nodes and antinodes and nodes and antinodes varying. So what we find is where we have a displacement node that corresponds to a pressure antinode, displacement is almost constant at zero, but the pressure is varying the most. And at a displacement antinode, where the amplitude is maximum, we find that the pressure is pretty much constant. We have a pressure node.